In this video, I'll present the basics of Tesla's wireless. When we hear the word wireless, we usually think of electromagnetic radiation through the air. But radiation, in general, is highly inadequate for sending industrial amounts of energy over moderate to long distances. Therefore, Tesla did not intend to use radiation, but conduction. In his experiments with high-frequency currents, Tesla discovered that the return wire can be replaced by a capacity. Thus, you only need one wire to transmit electrical energy. Thus, it would seem possible to use the Earth for this one wire. But this too does not work very well, he found. Plan B was to use the ionosphere either as a single wire or together with the Earth. Now things were starting to look more promising, but while in Colorado Springs, he discovered standing waves in the Earth, and that provided a far superior option. But are these standing waves possible in the Earth? In 1861, James Clerk Maxwell published his first version of his now famous equations. In 1864, he summarizes his previous work into 20 equations. Using modern factor notation, these can be rewritten into 8 equations. But when you search online for Maxwell's equations, you usually only find 4 which are derived from these 8. But wait a minute, did some term get ignored? Yes and no. It gets treated differently and is added when needed, as here in the Lorentz force. There is something unsettling about this force. This force seems to violate Newton's third law of motion. When I have two wires, both carrying a current, they exert a force on each other. Though these forces are equal in size, they are not opposed in direction. The common explanation is that you need to take the entire circuit into consideration, but that is not how Newton's law works. If I push the wall with my hand, the wall pushes back at my hand and not somewhere else. Did Maxwell not see this rather obvious error? No, he didn't, because he derived his equation from his model of the ether. And if you include the ether, then this problem gets resolved. But today's scientists do not want to hear about an ether, because it causes problems with relativity. Even though Einstein said that space without an ether is unthinkable, Maxwell's work does not allow for standing electromagnetic waves inside the Earth. But is that what Tesla was referring to? Tesla tried to answer the question, what is electricity? And went beyond Maxwell's model of the ether to find that it must be a gaseous medium. The difference between a charged and uncharged particle is in whether the medium around it interacts with it or not. How the medium interacts determines whether it creates a positive or negative charge. If the Earth were filled with this gaseous medium, longitudinal standing waves may be possible, exactly as he depicted. How then did Tesla intend to create this standing wave? First, we need to understand that the medium that Tesla refers to is not electrically charged. Instead, it is what causes electric charge in matter, both positive and negative. So if you have a Tesla coil with one end of its secondary grounded, when we switch it on, it will attract this medium. But as long as it's on, most of the medium will stay around the coil. According to Tesla, only a small portion, what he calls free electricity, moves in and out of the Earth. This portion can be increased by raising the top load. Although I have not yet found definite proof, I think that at Wardenclyffe, Tesla just set a sparker frequency to be in sync with the standing wave inside the Earth. This works perfectly, as I have found in my own experiments. The low frequency longitudinal standing wave compresses the medium, enabling the efficient propagation of higher frequencies, which would otherwise dissipate. The low frequency wave is the energy. The high frequency pitch just opens the valve in the receiver, thus allowing the energy to flow in. The resonance frequency of the Earth is about 11.77 Hz, according to Tesla. In our experiments, we have noticed a significant performance increase when the spark gap is triggered at this frequency or a multiple thereof. We have also been able to detect the echo of a pulse after 84.9 milliseconds, which matches the period of this frequency. And, in support of Tesla's gaseous medium, we found that an infrared thermometer shows a short peak when a Tesla coil is switched on and a short dip when it's switched off, showing compression and expansion of the medium respectively. Tesla intended to send electrical energy through the Earth. He saw the Earth as a reservoir of electricity, not charges, but a gaseous medium immersed in the fluid ether. This electricity could be set in motion, creating a standing wave. This has nothing to do with Schumann or Seneca. In fact, it is outside of the realm covered by Maxwell. With a tremendous standing wave present in the Earth, tuned high-frequency transmitters and receivers of relatively small proportions will be able to communicate signal and power efficiently and economically.